Only wish that you could deal with your own problems as well.
Such as?
Well, your neglect of your own precious child.
What are you talking about? Me neglect Laura?
Well, it does seem to me that you're leaving her with Mrs. Valentine more and more lately.
Don't you think that's natural? I don't have Mark around to help me.
Thank you.
Is that what this is about? Have you been talking to Mark?
Well, he is concerned about it, and I have to admit, in this case, I agree with him. Darling, it seems to me, ever since you took up
I have
Gilles,
not been neglecting my child because of Gilles, and I resent the insinuation that Mark has. But, excuse me.
Ah, Brooke, I'm so excited. I could carry you to the airport.
Put me down. I think I'd rather ride. Thank you.
What's going on here?
Where are you going?
Well, we have no time to talk about it now. We have to go.
I haven't
are
had a chance.
Back?
Yes, I am. I haven't had a chance to tell.
Well, now, just wait a minute. Will someone kindly tell me where you're off to?
On a private island in the Caribbean, where Brooke and I will be like Adam and Eve on the beach.
And you're here. Would you mind?
Brooke, this is madness. You can't just run off and leave this poor child.
Oh, Aunt Phoebe, please stop. I'm not running off and leaving her. And she loves Mrs. Valentine.
Well, she also loves her mother, whom she sees too little of these days.
She sees as much of me as she ever has. Now,
come on. Yeah,
there darling. You go. Show Aunt Phoebe your snake. Here you go. Here you go.
Thank you.
You're fine.
Yeah. You see? Now, I tell you, Brooke, it's not like you to do this. Gilles has turned your head.
Aunt Phoebe, if you say it's not like me to take a vacation, yes, you're right. But heaven knows I need one.
Brooke, we have to go now. We have to be there in 20 minutes.
Okay. Bye-bye, baby. Be a good girl. Mom will be back in a couple of days. Don't you worry. I'll call you, all right? And you don't... Okay?
Au revoir, Madame Morningford.
And do not worry, all right?
Okay, bye-bye, baby. Mama will call you. Bye.
Oh, don't worry, she says. Laura, she might as well ask me not to breathe.
Oh, fantastic setting, Case. Oh, I'd swear that wreath was real, except it's blue.
Oh, it's ice blue. It's a new winter color.
I hope you'd like it.
Yeah. Like it? I adore it. A real New Yorker's Christmas.
You want to cuddle up a little more to John? That's it, like before?
Certainly.
Great. You too. Smile up at him now. Ready?
Good.
Okay, sure. Ready?
Oh, it looks great to me.
Okay. Let's do it. Let's do it.
Darlings, right. Erica will adore this. Erica hates it.
Erica?
This is all wrong. This is not my concept at all. This was supposed to be a family Christmas layout, not Superman's ice house.
Erica, it's fabulous. Now, Case has outdone himself on this
Case
one.
Case has earned himself his walking papers. Get yourself another photographer.
Oh, Dolly, you've got to be kidding.
Case is the best in the business.
I am giving the orders here. And if you don't like it, Dabney, then you can leave, too.
Now I can't believe you mean that.
Believe it, Olga, believe it. Get all this trash out of here now.
Do yourself a favor. Go out there and tell them you've changed your mind.
You, Judas. You traitor. How dare you? How dare you undermine my authority?
Erica!
I don't mean you, Olga. I can live without you. I can live without everyone unless you can be loyal to me.
Well, if being loyal means standing by quietly and watching you destroy yourself, no, then I can't be.
And I thought you were my friend.
I am your friend. And Dabney is your friend.
Oh, please.
Oh, darling, he ran this magazine by himself, single-handed, while you were in Canada. He sat at that desk 24 hours around the clock, and he got the issue out on time. Well, he nearly killed him, but he was damned if he was going to let you down.
Well, I don't need Dabney. I can replace everyone in this staff if I want to. Everyone is expendable.
Except you.
I own Tempo magazine. This is mine to do with as I please.
Oh, all this isn't about fashion layouts or the magazine, is it? It's Jeremy. You're feeling rejected because he left town for good.
And to reject? I had no feelings for him. He was a friend, that's all.
A friend who saved your life.
For Mike. He did that to repay Mike for having saved his life one time, that's all. I mean, it was a job to Jeremy, you know. That's why he risked his life to save my life. Something he felt had to be repaid, so he repaid it, and now he went off to live wherever he was before.
Oh, Erica, lie to me if you want, but don't lie to yourself. You're in love with him.
Why do you keep saying that? I am not. It's Mike that I loved. You know that. Mike and Jeremy are just as different as day and night.
Darling, you've got to have the courage to face your feelings. I'm sure Jeremy did.
Why do you say that?
Because I've felt for a long time that Jeremy was in love with you.
Well, even if he was, it certainly wasn't returned.
Oh. Well, then why are you upset?
Well, I'm not upset about Jeremy. I am upset about Case and Dabney and all the rest of the incompetents around here.
Oh, darling, look, I am your friend. I am on your side. Please, Erica, for your own sake, just face it.
All right. I did care about Jeremy. I cared about him. He was the first man since Mike that I thought that I could trust and depend on. Only, Olga, I was wrong. He's not nearly the man Mike was. And I'm ashamed that I thought he was. I said I did care about Jeremy. I said I did trust Jeremy, but I realize now that he just wasn't worthy of it.
Oh, now you don't know that at all.
Olga, he walked out on me. He's never coming back.
Well, there just must have been a good reason.
I told you the reason.
You also told me that you were very close. Remember this morning, right after Jeremy left? I asked you then if you were in love with Jeremy. And you dismissed the idea with as much vehemence as you are right now. But obviously, it's been on your mind ever since.
And obviously, I misinterpreted Jeremy's feelings in Canada. I mean, you know, we were drawn together in a very dramatic situation. I mean, we were running for our lives from Adam. We were foraging food and firewood. It was all very primitive. And so naturally, we were just drawn together emotionally. But, you know, then we came back here and we got into reality and we realized that there was no future at all. I mean, look, I have to think about this as an episode in my life and I have to go on from there.
Darling, you can't go on anywhere unless you reconcile your feelings.
I thought I was in love with Jeremy.
And you still are.
Well, it doesn't do any good, does it? Because he's gone.
Oh, darling. He's in love with you.
Oh, you always were romantic.
I saw it in his eyes, and yes, I am romantic. You can't say anything that will convince me Jeremy doesn't love you.
Well, he walked out on me, didn't he? That's proof enough.
No, it isn't. He must have had some deep reason that he couldn't tell you.
Well, it doesn't matter anyway, because I don't need Jeremy in my life. I mean, I certainly have enough here that's going to keep me busy. I mean, just getting this magazine out, you know, is work enough.
I see. You're going to marry yourself to Tempo magazine.
Well, at least it's something I can count on. Just having an off day.
Well, we all have those, but I try not to take it out on the rest of the staff.
Yes, and I will certainly try to. I will try very hard in the future.
Does that mean it's okay to go ahead with the layout?
Well, I have already spoken to Case. He's accepted my apology, and if you will...
Oh, come on. I know what a rough time you've been through. It's okay, really. The important thing now is to get out the best magazine in the business.
Well, with you as my right-hand man, I will.
I better get to it.
Okay. Thank you, Dabney.
Thank you.
dans l'ombre de que je n'ai plus tes désirs, dans les silences de que je n'ai plus ton rire, comme un croyant à qui l'on a pu échanger. Je continue à vivre sans raison de vivre. J'ai besoin de toi, comme un arbre a besoin de pluie. J'ai besoin de toi, comme un homme a besoin d'oubli. J'ai besoin de toi, comme l'ombre a besoin du jour. Et je n'y peux rien, ton amour me tient. J'ai besoin de toi. J'ai besoin de toi pour savoir qu'il fait beau la nuit. J'ai besoin de toi pour mieux être ce que je suis. J'ai besoin de toi pour savoir que le temps est court et je n'y peux rien. Ton amour me tient. J'ai besoin de toi toujours, et je n'y peux rien, ton amour me tient, j'ai besoin de toi toujours.
Olive, I want you to get in touch with the airlines immediately. I want you to find the quickest, the earliest arrangements to get me to Tibet.
This experience of your entire life, and now you're taking off for Tibet?
Mother, please, I really don't have a lot of time to answer all these questions. I have all I can do to get home, get packed, and get out to the airport.
But this is madness. I mean, you don't even know that Jeremy is there.
Well, where else would he be, really, Mother? Of course,
well,
he's there.
How in the world would I know that, sweetheart? But even if you should find him at the monastery, you have no assurance that he's going to see you.
Well, that is a chance that I'll have to take.
Look, you're going to travel thousands of miles into an uncivilized country.
Mother, Tibet is not uncivilized.
And this time you're not going to even have Mark with you, honey. You're going to be completely, completely on your own.
Mother, Mike is there. And Cantu is there.
Cantu?
Cantu is the great teacher, the head of the lamasery. Cantu is the one who told me all about Mike's life while he was there writing his book, and about the brother that Mike saved his life. If this man was Jeremy.
It seems to me, honey, that you're equating the two. And that's why you're feeling so emotional about Jeremy.
No. No, that's not true. I know how I feel. I'm in love with Jeremy, and I think that he's in love with me.
But then why did he walk out on you?
That's what I'm going to find out, Mother, and until I do, I really cannot think of anything else, much less run this magazine.
Look, you're going to go halfway around the world looking for a man. Don't you know that you could get terribly hurt?